How many of you love studying? Would you please raise your hand? Okay. What about just like studying? Okay. What about don't really like studying? Okay. What about hate studying? Very excited crowd. Okay. So I have a confession. I belong to the second category. And that was always a challenge for me. As a medical doctor, a big portion of my job entails studying and reviewing knowledge. As Sir William Osler, the father of medicine, once said, a doctor is a student till he's dead. When he fails to be a student, he dies. I didn't want to die, so I had to figure out a way. I had to diagnose the problem and find a cure, a treatment for it. So I started attending so many lectures and courses about how to study, studying tips and tricks, smart ways of studying, creative ways of studying. But it always seemed that something was missing. The thing that led me to the cure to my problem was an Arabic proverb that repetition makes smart people learn. And donkeys too. تكرار يعلم الشطار والحمار برضو. So I thought maybe if I can make this repetition a smart process, maybe I can change the entire way of studying. Maybe I can make it more effective. So I traced repetition and I found that the first person who described it clearly was a German psychiatrist, a German psychologist, and his name is Hermann Ebbinghaus. He described it in 1885. He basically was trying to do the same thing. He got a list and he was trying to memorize that list and test himself on different times and occasions. What he found was the forgetting curve. He found that, and if we plot time versus retention, which is basically how much he would remember. If he started studying at day zero without reviewing the material, the forgetting curve would look like exponentially decaying curve. Like he would forget a big chunk of the information in the first few days, and he would hold on and hang on some items of the list to the end. However, when he started to review the list at increasingly spaced intervals, he noticed that the forgetting curve would start to flatten out and he would get much longer time of retention than the time he would get without reviewing it. Now that was kind of important, and as we sometimes say, was very, very, very important. But how to apply it needed me to find more research about that. So I found two studies speaking about that. One of them that doctors and residents without spaced repetition, they forgot up to 30% in the first year, 30% of the basic science knowledge in the first year. And in the second year, without reviewing the information, they forget up to 50%. Another study showed 40% greater retention of information when spaced repetition is applied. So obviously, that was the diagnosis. That was the correct problem. I needed to make my repetition smarter. The solution and the way that I found was actually, and surprisingly, pretty simple. It was actually simple. It was a card. Now, this is a blank card, a white card that you can purchase from anywhere, the same size of a business card, and you can actually make it from paper. But when you write a question on one side of it, and an answer on the other side, this transforms to a very powerful learning tool. And the way I got to benefit from Ebbinghaus, forgetting curve, and spaced repetition concept was through something called the Leitner boxes. Leitner boxes, basically there are four boxes. So you are studying, you are breaking down the syllabus, the information, into small questions, card by card. So you are studying, you are creating cue cards, questions, and questions, and questions. So let's say this is the daily one. This box number one, you review it every day. Box number two, you review it every other day. Box number three, you review it every week. Box number four, you review it every month. Each time you get a question right, it graduates to the next box. And each time you get a question wrong, it goes all the way to the beginning, to box number one, no matter where it was. Now, how this helped is that it allowed me to spend less time on the information that I already mastered, and more time on the information that I need to focus more on. Cue cards are active studying tool, which allow active recall. Now, while we are studying, we obviously know that our brains can play tricks on us, and we can confuse recall with recognition. Like, you can see information and think, okay, this looks familiar, I know this, but if I cover the page and ask myself, would I know everything in that page? I might not know it. Well, that's the difference between recall and recognition. Questions are very powerful because they use active recall in reviewing the information. Cue cards are portable. You can carry them everywhere. On the beaches, on the fields, on the hills, and on the streets. Cue cards are cards. You can play cue cards now. Imagine that studying can be a game. You can play with your friends with these cue cards. They can really engage in an interesting game with you. Cue cards now make studying clear. It's a clear process. Whenever you are studying, you are either creating cue cards or you are reviewing cue cards. When you are creating cue cards, you don't worry about memorizing the information. You only worry about making it creative, writing the cue cards in a way that is pleasant and easy, and using your own words and understanding in rephrasing the information. When you are reviewing the cue cards, there is no stress. It's gonna go through the flow. It's gonna run its course. And sooner or later, you're gonna master that information, because repetition will make you get it in your memory. Cue cards can be digital. Living in the world of the internet, we can today find spaced repetition apps. There are apps in your smartphones where you can create cue cards and review cue cards, and the application, the free application, will worry about when to let you know when to review it, based on each single cue card, how well you remember each single cue card. And because it's digital, you can add a picture, a video to be the answer to that question. You can even use your own voice to be the answer to the questions you create. These cue cards, like building blocks for your knowledge. And as you go through the way, the journey of learning, they will increase, not only in number, but also in size. Each cue card, you will find pictures, videos, analogies, examples that match each single cue card that you can add it to them along the way. Each cue card will be safe because it's properly maintained and reviewed. I wish that one day libraries would have sections for cue cards on them, where you can create your own cue cards and donate them, or somebody else can do the same and you can borrow them, and everybody else can benefit from it by uploading it into a cloud on the internet. I wish that one day schools and universities will provide a curriculum in a form of questions. Big questions and smaller questions. Because if we get all the smaller questions answered, answering the big questions will become much easier. Thank you.